Nowadays, both Unreal Engine and Unigine have amazing water systems, but which one is better? In this video, we will take a look at what both have to offer, such as types of water bodies, customization and performance, and decide which water system is better. So let's start with the available water bodies. What I mean by that is lakes, oceans and rivers. The ocean is exactly what you would expect in either engine. Pretty much a seemingly infinite plane that uses a water material. There isn't much that you can customize about it besides the material, but more on that later. Lakes, on the other hand, allow for more customization. Unigine lets you create lakes by using primitive meshes, such as planes, or if you're aiming for precise results, you can shape it after a custom mesh. Unreal has these features as well, but it goes a level higher by letting us define the shape of the lake using splines. Splines are points that form a closed curve in this case. Additionally, these splines will directly edit the landscape. What I mean by this is that the terrain will adjust itself to make things look natural. I hope you can see just how powerful this is. Let's move to rivers. These are only available in Unreal currently. They work based on splines and influence the landscape just like lakes. What's so great about this is how intuitive the process is. Drag a river in the scene, adjust the spline point's position, and that's it. Literally that simple. Furthermore, you can connect a lake and an ocean by a river and it will automatically blend. According to Unigine devs, rivers are coming to their engine, but they haven't given us an estimated time yet. But what about customization? How can you make this fit your environments? First of all, we can change the parameters of the waves. In Unigine, you get access to 4 different waves whose directions and heights can be precisely adjusted. In Unreal, you can use as many waves as you want, but with less control over individual waves. They are, in a sense, procedurally generated based on minimum and maximum values. Foam is a big deal in Unreal Engine. That's because you can realistically simulate foam on top of objects, such as rocks in an ocean, that will flow back over time. That is important because it shows that we can bind water with the new Niagara particles. Unigine keeps foam quite simple by using a foam texture that appears when the surface is crossed by an object. Other than that, both support pretty realistic foam on top of waves. Caustics work similarly in both engines, but there is one major difference. Unreal uses a volume texture to look for caustics that are then projected onto the landscape. Unigine uses a classic animated 2D texture. Moreover, Unreal offers a solution to generate caustics inside the engine, so you don't have to deal with creating that yourself. This generator can be very helpful to achieve accurate results. We also need to tackle material properties. By this, I mean the physical properties such as subsurface scattering, refraction, and so on. Unreal enables you to change a lot of properties. So many that going through all of them would take too long. On the other hand, Unigine keeps the parameters at a minimum, but that will not restrict you from customizing it. This is a double-edged sword, because too many parameters can confuse you and too little can restrict you. Besides these, there are some geometry settings present in both engines, such as tessellation, but those aren't that big of a deal. What I do like more about Unreal when it comes to customization is that the material is mostly made using nodes. This can be really helpful if you want to take a deep dive and understand how the material was created. Unfortunately, this cannot be done in Unigine as it is not open source. But how is their performance? The current Unreal water system has been used in Fortnite for quite a while now, and on both desktop and mobile the water runs well. Unreal has proven that it runs well, that it is production ready, and that it scales across different devices. Unigine doesn't tell us much about performance, but from my experience, even on high settings, it runs perfectly smooth on my machine. That might not be the same for you, so definitely try it out yourself if you're interested. So, which engine has the better water system? While there are a lot of questions to be asked, such as are you developing this for a game or purely for an environment, personally I like Unreal's solution more overall. Not necessarily because of its rivers and automated terrain matching, but I like having more control over it. As well, there is more information on performance, which is definitely handy for games. However, I love how insanely good Unigine's water looks out of the box. Definitely check out both if you're interested in knowing what these beasts can really achieve. Which water system do you like more? Tell me through a comment. I can't wait to hear your opinions on this one. Be sure to subscribe for more videos just like this one and hit that bell if that's your thing. Perhaps consider supporting my work over on Patreon like these kind people. Aviramai FM, Badr Al-Kaktani, Giovanni Pena, Golden Glow Master, Leonardo Pereira, Realitas Verlast, Taman Gehring, and C.YW. Now, if you want to see a general comparison between Unreal and Unigine, I got a video just on that right here. That's it from me, folks. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.